this committee hearing of the Committee on Civil Service, Government Organization, and Professional is hereby called to order. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you very much for joining us. May I ask the committee secretary to read for the record the agenda for this afternoon?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. For today's agenda, Act 553, an act regulating the practice of mining engineering in the Philippines, repealing Public Act 1274 as amended, entitled Engineering Law of the Philippines and for other purposes. B. Revised Environmental and Sanitary Engineering Act, Senate Bill Number 559, an act providing for a more responsive and comprehensive regulation for the practice and environment and sanitary in the Philippines for purpose and for other Sanitarians Professionalization Act. Number 5, an act of regulation and professional license administration of sanitarians. D. Philippine Plumbing Engineering Act. Cell number 5, regulating the practice of plumbing engineering in the Philippines, amending for the purpose Republic Act number 1871, regulating master plan. Appropriating for other Senate 49, deleting the practice of plumbing engineering in the Philippines. E. The entry executives 261 clearing and the federal to executive service 607. An act the doctorate service. F. Automatic promotion of government and government. 0. Promotion of upon return government service. An act to promote and employment retirement purposes. Internship number 3 plus is implement internship in France and for last General Integration Act, Senate Bill number 507, an act integrated falls. To be for the Bureau of Correctional Services, appropriating funds thereof and for
thank you very much, Mr. Secretary. We'll just tweak the order a bit. So since the resource persons for the Jail Integration Act already here are all present, so we can dispense with number 5. Attorney De Los Santos, are you ready to report?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead, please, sir.
The information of yours. The copies of the documents relating to the appearance of Attorney Lim, our chief legal office. Attorney Lim on April 20 received a suspension order from the Department of Justice, Your Honor, and he has not been reported for since April 20. And to ensure to help play. We endeavor to tell the your honor, Lucena, and unfortunately, the one found that the said residents refused to accept the notice, but a process server tendered this honor. Likewise, my sister was able to and yet he declined, saying that he would rather in because that I would to comply with your honor's request. And for this amount to sell not only your apply for the
okay, we'll just react accordingly, Attorney De Los Santos. Anyway, are you ready to give any report regarding the bill 07?
Yes, sir.
We need to. Do you need, for example, on the assumption that this bureau would be turned over to you? How much do you need in terms of withdrawal, jail, etc. And include the of new person that we
want to with minor financial component. Because right now, viewpoint is in the first stage of implementation of the modernization law 2013. And for the first year of budget EBM, we already submitted a budget proposal for from 2.3 billion annual. We now presented 18 billion because of the increase. Afterward, rate by 5 to 10.
I understand, Director Boss. The base requested is in relation to the organization, the salaries. But, if you are well aware the need to do some assumption that track new part so that we have an idea how much we actually need and how personnel we actually need. So, because these are questions that would be asked of me once I sponsor this bill.
Right now, Your Honor, I can say for the decision for 150. Of the jail integration program that would include how to jail to include the level, maybe be allowed, Your Honor, to present a more intelligent budget.
What we want not necessarily build the plan or work estimate because that will give it magnitude. If you're talking of 100, you can just formula the cost is now just approximate the number of of personnel, number of employees or prisoners that you have, then more or less you can have an idea. And plus, of course, the number of personnel that when related to us, it is to be composed of this was we were reviewing everything. So for sponsored so we'll give you enough time for that, so please help us. Okay, thank you very much. Okay. Ano naman? Okay. Yeah. Without or excuse, sir, person, director,
you are not.
Yes, please. Now suspension of number 50. Move to 53. Mining Engineering Act. Civil can get your
support staff and paper has revised. So probably within the week we can submit that.
Okay, thank you. Chair? Chair?
Mentioned the adjustment from the 5-year to the 4-year course in the curriculum might affect provision and should also curriculum.
In what major
is
in the major
some of the put in senior high, so those will not be covered in the board exams anymore.
Mm.
So not
who gave you the authority to do that?
That's part of the chat too, because we went into the K-12, so chat has been for engineering year 5 years.
Yan ngayon kaya ba? No? Na kula?
Ang kula the basic which was addressed
okay 4 years. 4 years magkakaproblema tayo dyan. Sana inaano nyo muna to eh. Ang kontra to kito to you okay to deal with those to equip behind the for higher education hindi pa niyan.
All of the engineering courses have been studied year program already. Mm-hmm. And all of the technical panels and technical committees mm-hmm. have streamlined the courses because of the adjustment.
You see, are you that reduction? Napag-usapan niyo na ba ito?
You're unaware of that.
Nako.
Many of our discussion.
Okay, yung PRB ng Mining Engineering.
Your Honor, I am Mr. Casido. I represent the Board of Engineering. But the revision engineering curriculum.
Having heard niya, may
nabot. Your Honor, but I am not amenable to bring it down to 4-year score. Dapat pangatagdagan pa natin kasi kulang eh.
So, wag kayong, kasi malaki yung repercussions niyan. Alam niyo na, I've been going around to different over the in dagdagan yung basic. Hindi sinasabing bawasan yung yung college, yung degree. Diba?
Your hearing, sir, and the some of the hearing PRBs are part of the technical committees. So, on the last hearings already, and
pero, PRBs... Wait, yung K-12 is only for the basic
education. Yes, sir.
Yan. Bihin naman yung higher education kayo ng batas na sa actions ninyo. Sa akin, kung estudyante lang yung magulang, natural, matutuwa yan sila. But, engineers, kasi pinapalitan mo, remember, high school student, kung high school student, sabi ko nga, umpak ng brother Armin, yung mindset ng high school student, pang high school yan. Yung lalakad puro ng high school, yung retention, kalaro lang. Iba yung mindset. But college, merong lan, may pa yan. Mas sabi sila may diin. And that replace now
bring it up with the committee panels addressing this.
Okay. You don't have concerns ng mga employers domestically at internationally. Okay, i-float nyo lang. Ano masasabi niyo kunyari may yung engineer namin ay for you lahat pa natin dito talo na where the OFWs are. So ayaw natin magiging problema kasi i-reverse niyan. Okay? So and oh sige.
Just one more thing we would like stated that there are it's to the professional in some section.
Mm-hmm.
It should be said that always be a visit. Visit with the presence of shed.
Okay. Any comment on
inspection and sheds be done in with now in prepare well schedule it's that the visits are scheduled
hindi sila available.
They are not available, so we get approval from them doctor with our shed representative and we are allowed to do that. So it has been a common practice that we inform them but available the inspection
to seek approval.
We let them
inform them.
Yes.
Okay, that's good enough. Ngayon, kung hindi kayo, kung busy kayo sa chat, kung pwede yung... So, by in the PRB, to be more active, as your school, otherwise, kasi naririnig ibang opinion, tutuloy yan, and to the detriment of the option affected.
Like, all the engineers have a technical panel, and the technical they have been on the
mga IPO integrated professional organizations, non-professions, dapat eh, yung mga bagong graduates eh, less than one compared to edi so mag-consult. K to 2,000 nakapag-uminto school ha yan plus the employers abroad makuha ni nasa gala nyo looking yun na yun eh kasi ang back san engineering ako eh hindi mo alam kung paano mo babawasan yung siksik na nga eh plus kung ipapasa mo naman sa halong yung mind ba? Anyway
may I read technical session
okay hindi na rito give them a pro picture mga professionals ha?
The professionals are already part of the technical panels
yung siguro yung professional panel speak and then it's a really going emerging professional kasi meron ang value ba implement yan eh anyway
Your Honor that leads to the bill for the 60 engineering we have some out to lawyers for professionals. There's a professional mining engineer, registered miner, and foreman registration engineer of all four and who have this in my we welcome we would like experience of on creation of different there is a proposal to ban the use of other professional titles than person as an this is something to because space qualified title we have to review mission and the proposal technical standards to pass approval of the PRC with the two-thirds affirmative vote of all mining engineering practitioners. The standards are supposed to be and supposed to be approved by the board and the commission. So, we also inclusion integration of mining engineers, the IPO.
Okay.
So generally we support it but with some amendments.
Okay, very much. The PRC mining engineer.
Thank you. The 553 by Senator is in January. Okay. In fact, we fully support the bill. However, we just want to input some improvements and harmonization with allied professions, okay, particularly geology and metallurgical engineers, because these two professions have their own from mining engineers. We just want these three harmonize any in the geology law, which has just been passed, with the geological engineer. Gusto lang natin as a couple commission, there are comments of the TO guidelines which we, and here we are speaking about ASEAN APEC engineers that are, while we are signatory, not touch it the same, and also in the down of DNR, again, it is not yet a law. So we cannot use them as reference or as a basis for making a law. Okay. On this basis, at Mare Pangiba, Your Honor, kami pong nagkasundo sa professions. Tatlo po kami sa mining eh. Geologist, miners, nagkaroon kami summit at yung
okay,
we'll come up with a final version of your bill within 30 days. It should be able to the next honor.
We will definitely that, and we cannot move forward. You resolve. Thank you very much, Engineer. Next, we
thank you, Your Honor.
We proceed to the Engineer Castillo, Secretary.
I believe it would be best that we would still have the harmonization first before we go to final versions, Your Honor.
Okay. Salamat. Next, we put my mining operated. Kalano.
Good afternoon, everyone. We submitted this afternoon missions of the final bill was 1,007, and the lot of changes specifically was the question about it protection. This is engineers who do not go ahead ask about anybody mining. Matter who wrote was required
minimum number of
mining engineers required technology and minimum number of certified 949. We also amendment during the month to be a license because we have increasing things which are essentially just nothing to particularly it's and
the bill amendments and some concerns.
Some slight amendments.
But remember, this is just a professional regulatory law ending the mind here. So while we understand the concerns and we recognize that those are important, we just state that it is included. Thank you very much. Proceed. Bakit gustong, oh, DOJ?
Good afternoon, sir, and everyone. We have already positioned, just we would include issues raised by the other agencies, like, for example, just in our own, like, to organize the issues with our inputs. So, just a manifestation, Your Honor. We would like to request copies of the inputs that of Chair ARC.
Before we do that,
we were comment on
akala going in the government presented here. Okay. Madagdagan.
Okay.
Yeah.
More of constitutional and of the mesh. That's the.
Palagay ko i yes yes.
Chairperson.
Kung naman para hindi na rin kayo ma pardon. Ito niyo yung akin. Ma'am, we can suspend the consideration of Senate 55. Sino bang magtatanong tungkol ay magsasalita regarding 553? No one else?
Maybe excuse.
Yes, ma'am, pasok na. Nagkaroon lang ng ano dito.
Okay.
Mix up.
Thank you.
Thank you. Excuse mga engineer.
I'm the past president of the Philippine Society of Mining Engineers. Okay. And I would like to state for the record that the submitted 8.53. The Mr. Chair, essential a maximum of 7 months to conduct consultations on the amendments of the
bill.
We have chapter means would like the of the amendment members of society really what is prepared.
Ito na lang. Siguro anyway information age tayo. Try to expedite the dissemination process. Kasi antayin na lang natin si Engineer kasi Engineer Kala station. But after that we'll have to move on. Okay? Anyway, you are the officers, you're supposed to be the representative of the association.
Yes, sir. Submitted our and to harmonize with the and other sector.
But be assured that you're not happy.
Thank you.
You are not happy. I will move it forward. Okay, so we need your inputs here. We need facts from Bill Draft, as mentioned, a lot since then. We need so those number five by excuse. Thank you. We now move to number five. Please, ma'am.
Yes, Your Honor, for the record, we also support the proposed bill and was beset this week.
Thank you. Chair?
Just a point of 559 is amending the incorporating environmental sanitary engineering from the sanitary engineering profession. This would be subject to review because the curriculum of sanitary engineering does not include environmental concerns, specifically on toxic waste and hazardous waste. So it provision nakalagay mention sanitary be environmental and sanitary engineers, it should include things on especially conditions are for them to like the current as mental not ESG on is still in still
so that's the reason for so that is to curriculum incorporate.
Yes sir, because in the PSG that they're developing now the toxic and hazardous waste is covered by legal engineering. Engine domestic,
but is concerned them to have also idea about these things. We're not talking about the board, we're not talking about or the scope of profession, we're just talking about the curriculum. I believe
yes, it would be a plus for the environmental and sanitary engineers, but our concern is it will be overlapping with other.
As far as education is concerned, there is no overlap. Overlap in the profession. So, engineer. De La Cruz, so
I would still request that further study on this will be before the CHED gives a position paper, because as environmental engineers are part that is why curriculum, but they are of 5 years and that will be still subject to consideration.
Okay. So, just tell me, anong basis nung ano nyo? Anong basis pag curriculum 4 years?
Actually, there is a reduction 4 years. It was a direction from the chair to
there is no if there is no law that's tenuous. So ano yan? any major subject, ano na?
Assumption that year college supposed to be high school subjects will
no choco yung electronics and subjects 12 so 3 trimesters 4 major so paano nyo
sir sa senior high are the mathematics and sciences
hindi mula yung mathematics sa iba pa yung electrical and electronic subjects namin
the electronics will still be in the professional level
So yun na nga, hindi mo pa rin ma-reduce. Wag, sa akin, huwag nilang pilitin. Pwede siguro ma-lighten yung load nila. Huwag masyadong kunin. Anyway, so, sige. Anyway, we are just informing you basically that we have this web. Will be to this inquiry but it's done have to comply okay next PRC
Your Honor in PRC there is no general move to reduce the number of years of courses that's a general move. On the points in Bill 5. Mm-hmm. The commission has no objections. Particularly the ending of the word professional and environment and sanitary licensure examination to be open to other engineering graduates provided that they have masteral units in environmental or public health. There are two points which depends to instead the issue of the certificate of registration where it says by the professional regulation chairman but we do have a question a clarification on the inclusion of additional category of the professional the sanitarian because section is for the professional words so we need to include the sanitarian in this bill That's all, Your Honor.
Thank you very much. Chairman of the Board of Sanitary Engineering of PR Engineer Romero.
Good afternoon, Chairman, Honorable Senator. The member of the Regulatory Board for Sanitary Engineering of the Professional Regulation Commission would like to express its full Senate 59 with utmost humility and may your office expedite this because this has been already been since 80s, almost 20 or 19. Enacted.
Mm-hmm.
So we are now on the 20th and the millennial years.
Yeah.
So okay. We would like to request that this particular bill be approved.
Okay. Thank you very much, Engineer. Maybe not the Society of Engineers.
The Philippine Society of Sanitary Engineers fully supports the proposed amendment by
Huh? Umalis na yung DNA? Anyway. Committee Secretary, kuhaan na lang natin yung ano, position paper. H? Sino? DOH, ma'am. Miss Karating?
Position paper for this proposed bill will be submitted to your office this week. You have not yet finalized the position paper for the Department of Health.
Okay. Thank you. Anybody else who would like good yes.
We support bill for matters are land and river pollution and solid waste management. For short manifestation, Your Honor, sanitary pollution is a for less than first. All town United States and other countries are now using the professional name environmental engineers. Mm-hmm. And with that, all the schools now offer this profession, this field, sanitary but then have to take the pending the approval of this we'd like to see the day if this situation cannot be addressed, the county might be importing environmental engineers just for the this profession, the sanitary engineering. So we got body 3 years we passed law. Thank you, Your Honor. I'm Julian Engineer Lara. I'm our boss. Smash.
That all the concerned resource persons for the next probably we suspend Senate Bill 2 Senate 0 Sanitarians Professionalization Act.
Pinatawag.
Okay, we go through the rounds again, Civil Service Commission.
Actually, this part also, sir, along with the Environment and Sanitary and the other, but we ask you, Sanitary Inspection or it's just a matter of clarifying.
Sorry, the...
Yeah, because in the description, we have the Sanitary and the intention you sanitary inspector, because under the IOS of the DBM, we use the sanitary inspector. So are we going to change that or we use the sanitary?
The company will be note of
the chair is not against licensing the sanitary inspectors, yeah. But the concern creation of another degree, the BS Sanitary degree. Primarily on the concern that sanitary inspectors are professionals who are inspecting, and the focus is they should be qualified based on their training and skills. So they don't have to be really a degree holder to be a sanitary inspector, because there are other professionals who can do inspections already. So creating another degree would more or less complicate matters because of the presence already of other professionals like sanitary engineers who are qualified to do sanitary inspection, chemical engineers who specialize in food can also do sanitary inspection. The Department of Health with the FDA can also do sanitary inspection. So use creation of another degree is not actually supported by the chair.
So, paano po? There will be a board. So, ano magiging basis niya?
It's like when you get it, we have been having talks with that's why the sanitary engineers are creating the title of sanitarian. Mm-hmm. So that would be equivalent to them handling the sanitary inspector licensing. That's why they mentioned it in the
okay. We will get their position. So next is okay, ma'am.
Your Honor, we believe that there's no need to create another professional regulatory board at PRC, but rather focus on qualifications and the competencies of the inspectors, like maybe requiring the sanitary inspectors to have a professional license on their own,
okay.
Like for sanitary engineering or chemical engineering, but not to create another board.
Okay.
Your Honor.
The chairman of the Board of Sanitary Engineering. Yes.
Good afternoon again, Your Honor. For your information, we had a prior agreement with the sanitarians that they will now be under the care of the sanitary engineers. After all, sanitarians who are employed now in the Department of Health are being trained by the sanitary engineers, because we are only very few, the sanitary engineers. It was prior for DOH and the sanitary engineers to get undergrad college students to be trained for 6 months, I think, who are now the sanitarians. But they only take care on matters of public health and sanitation aspects, Your Honor.
Okay. Thank you very much, Engineer Lara. Can we get first the position of the League of Sanitation Inspectors of the Philippines?
Sir, I am the newly elected president of the League. Option Queen, I will support the Sanitary Engineers proposal bill, which is 552 to the professionalization of the sanitarians in our country.
Wait, this is 580
of the sanitarians, yes. In support to the 552, 580.
5-8-0.
Okay.
So, 580. What can you say about the concerns raised by the sanitary engineers and CHEP?
Because until now, we are facing the water problems at the Department of Health, and we are still receiving a salary of 7.6. And most of our sanitarians are first to use the service now at our personal upgrading of salaries. So, we are hoping
sanitary engineers.
Well, sir, it is a risk. We are still under the sanitary engineers.
Okay,
because of our aspect.
So, engineer, what do you first?
Yes, engineer. Actually, sir, your proposed guideline includes the sanitary and standard arts.
Okay.
We fully support that. An integrated, will be integrated under our profession. And therefore, like that, they will also be regulated by the professional regulatory board, professional engineers as well.
Okay.
Just like the master electricians, just like under the electrical engineers, just like the certified plant mechanics, under the certified plant engineers. You need to follow that line, you know.
Okay, thank you very much.
About upgrading is the BBM jurisdiction. It's actually if you are, we cannot actually assist on that, on the upgrading. It's actually based on the functions of the position.
So
the part of the position would call for a reclassification or a change of salary grade. I think they can do that, sir. Yeah, so.
Step increases lang.
Not necessarily, sir. They can do some upgrading with approval of the DBM. They can just represent on DBM that they are doing function higher than the existing functions. Duties and responsibilities are.
So, if there is a, was this a level of, between the frontline and, for example, the supervisory position, then you are eligible for the increase in salary grade, because the salary grade is not fixed on the profession per se, the profession, but well, anyway, we'll it's a challenge. We'll try to find a way to increase, but we're increasing also the salary through the salary standardization law, so everybody gets to have an increase along those lines. Plus, the step increments would now become higher also because of the difference between salary grades. So, I don't know if that would suffice, but in the concerns of the other stakeholders, it may actually be detrimental to your profession should we push through with this. Okay. So we'll just coordinate with DPM how we can help you with the increase in your salary grade. So if you can just provide our office regarding your position position paper, for example, then we can transmit it to DPM.
More or less, 3,000 plus ang aming member po sa league, but throughout the country, maybe not more than that.
But, ano po,
government?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Government lahat.
Sir,
actually, sir, we have submitted our
session letter last 2015.
For the salary grading.
Okay. DBM, what can you say about that? Are you ready to answer on behalf of
Your Honor? We will wait for the formal communication before.
Sige. But intindihan yung concerns nila, ano, kasi matagal na sila dun sa position na yun. Paano pa naman sila may increase dun sa ng salary grade, di ba? Para naman meron kang foresight na naingganyo kang magtrabaho dahil meron kang nakikita ang proposal at some point in the future. So it's a challenge. Civil service, palagay ko hindi lang sa sanitary inspectors ito. Yun yung challenge sa akin. Kasi yung, sa akin sa airports, meron yung longevity pay na tinatawag. Yung longevity pay na kahit steady ka lang dun sa trabaho mo, pero after every 5 years, nagagawa ko yung sweldo mo
yung GPT pay na nakapit sa salary grade mo. And, ano yun, it's something that they can avail of. From that, committee secretary, ano, regarding an equivalent sa GPT pay. I'm sure kumakain na naman ang DBM to, but we'll give it a shot anyway. Parang ganun. So, yun po. Okay? With that, we need to stand in consideration of engineer lang.
Just to clarify, sir. The sanitarians and sanitary inspectors are using the sanitation code under the DOH to inspect facilities. They also inspect based on the National Building Code in Chapter 9 on sanitation. So, we need to know.
So, I believe you have that covered. We are in agreement. So, we will put this aside and you just work on your bill. Okay. Ma'am?
I have here the position paper of the Philippine Institute of Chemical Engineers. I just would like to submit a copy.
Oh, Philippine what?
Institute of Chemical Engineers.
Which one? Okay,
I can just submit.
A page, pakikuha mo na position paper. Thank you very much, ma'am. So, without, you know, Senate Bill number 592. So, kung hindi na kayo relevant sa bills na ito, you are excused. Your excuse. Are you please submit na rin yung position paper regarding 580, ha? Thank you. So, salamat po. Antayin natin yung ano nyo, ha? At yung position paper nyo. Tapos, sige po. We'll communicate to DBM. GB. 592 is Planning Engineering Act, Civil Service. Ala. Okay, lumabas. Chair, please.
Your Honor, the Chair wants to clarify because the design in construction of any building or facility is still under the civil engineers, the sanitary engineers, and the chemical engineers, and the mining engineers. The role of plumbers is just to follow the design stated by those mentioned engineers. So if the plumbing will have a separate engineering profession, this might be in contradiction to the design already set by the chemical engineers, the mining engineers, and so the concern is really if there is really a need to create a plumbing engineering profession.
Okay, we'll ask the PRC about it.
Your Honor, we have reservations on this bill. And that our recommendation on whether or not to support the plumbing engineering bill is predicated on SHED's position insofar as the curriculum designed for the proposed BS in plumbing engineering is concerned. We would like to defer the matter so that we can have further consultation because we would like to assure that there are no overlapping in the scope of work.
Okay. Let's ask the chairman of the Board of Master Planner, PRC.
Good afternoon, Your Honor.
Good afternoon.
I am Engineer Manila, chairman of the Board of Master Planners at PRC. First of all, we support bill to upgrade the master planner train to a profession since it has been a long time that it was passed.
And secondly, we need to have a time to chat and to talk about this, the relevance of planning and planning engineering into the construction industry. Because in some other countries, there is that plumbing engineers also. And if you have to relate to other countries, then you should also be on the same level with them. And as for the practice, we have our own tool, we have our own manual designing, so we feel that we can qualify to be a professor also, Your Honor.
Maraming salamat po. Engineer Ilagan.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, so a master planner is not under any profession. It's not under the civil engineer. It is not under the sanitary engineer. And if you will look at rule 3 of section 301 about ancillary permit, master planner permit, master planner permit is separate from any other profession. And actually, this is stated in the planning board of the Philippines that no permit shall be issued to any person, firm or corporation, unless the permit has been the drawings and specification has been signed and sealed by a master planner. Also, the permit should be issued only to a master planner. It is clearly stated in the National Building Code that a master planner is a separate profession, not under any other profession. And we, the master planner, together with the board of master planner, want to professionalize our profession. And only stated, it is stated in the RA 1378 that the board of master planner shall only have the upgrading in the planning profession from time to time to the condition affecting the trade of master planner in the Philippines, and we know the necessary. Recommend to the President of the Philippines the adoption of such rules and regulations as may be deemed proper for the maintenance of good ethics and standards in the trade and for the protection of the public property in consultation with different master planner associations. Nothing mentioned in this RA 1378 under protection except the master planner only. Thank you, Your Honor.
Let me first acknowledge the presence of Senator Barrapino. Sir, thank you very much for joining us. We're not trying to diminish the master planner training profession. What this bill is about is whether it will be upgraded into a profession that will be regulated by it's now regulated by the PSC.
Yes.
Right? Whether it should be upgraded into a full engineering course. So that is what we're trying to figure out. And so but for now we're seeing some issues. So we suggest Engineer Ilaga and Engineer Manila to consult with Chair and PRP. So until you can actually resolve those issues, we cannot move ahead. Okay? So?
Sir, the House Bill number 5070 May 25, 2015 is already passed in the House of Representatives. Provided to your honorable committee, sir.
Okay, what the problem here is this. If there are stakeholders that have concerns or may be affected by any bill, that's going to be a major funding block. We'll need to answer this on the floor. So, by practice of this committee, we resolve issues
I?
Yeah, please.
So in the national report, after the filling permit, it was confirmed. It is clearly stated that the sanitary permit and the plumbing permit is a different for people. It is clearly stated, sir, and clearly stated that the document pertaining to plumbing to people can only be signed.
Society of Plumbing Engineers, when we have an organization, it is based on a profession. As of now, we are still in the process of deliberating on the engineering, on the plumbing engineering law. So,
this is in question.
I will not be a referee in this debate. So, hindi natin diminish again. We're not diminishing the master-planning trade and profession. Ang nire-result na natin is how to move forward in this bit. Again, sabi ko nga, that's probably the solution to this. So how are we regulating the master plumbers right now? How what are the qualifications, the basic qualifications?
In the old law, in the existing law, it is basically a graduate of a high school graduate plus 5 years of plumbing experience.
Okay. So, do you think that that is not sufficient? You want it to be a full degree?
That is what you like, sir, because of the complexities of the plumbing systems now.
Mm-hmm. So, sige. Well, anyway, sabi ko na, I will encourage you to consult, to talk with them. Narinig nyo naman yung mga positions nila. There's no use fighting over this. Ako, I cannot adopt a single position because can you take all the people? I expect everybody to be on board. What do you do to start on the clock? What do you mean? May I be talking that is the challenge, lalo na kung issues, diba? Diba? So, I don't need that problem. Sure. So, sige, what?
The concern right now, sir, is the Commission on Higher Education. Because do you know that there is no curriculum yet for planning engineering?
No. Not only that. It's about the need. The need to upgrade to a professor. So, yun yung issue nila. Ako, meron akong pinayabil precisely to avoid the concerns, but they have concerns as well. Ayaw na magkaroon ng conflict about it. So, ayusin nila muna doon. Kausapin nyo, pick an audience, you present the things, then try to win the program. Na there is a need for the upgrading of your profession. At the same time, mag-arami yung ibang profession na hindi sila tatamaan. Di ba? At the same time, will students start to work? That's the next problem. Dito, is there a demand for it? Di ba? Sige, sa inyo, Engineer Ilagan. Dahil po magpapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapap makikita being a lucrative career in the future. So, ayan.
Sir, what do you want to say in this role like the sanitation? It is not talking about the planning, a planning profession. Sanitation involves the working environmental factor, which is the industrial hygiene, which deals with mechanical about ventilation, which deals with electrical engineering about electrical illuminating level, and other professions are actually which involve sanitation. It is not about sanitary engineering. And I just want to inform the Honorable Senator that they will never be left behind because they are part of this law that we are trying to help enact sanitary and other professions that are then they speak that tinatawag natin na automatic registration without the examination. So, wala pong maiiwan dito na nakasama sila sa support na ito towards professionalism na ating master plumber profession, master plumber engineering.
Well, again, sabi nga, I'm with you. Wala pong problema sa akin. Ang problema is dun sa ibang stakeholders. So, ako, I don't see myself sponsoring any billionaire other top issues na stakeholders. So, that's essential and integral dun sa legislative process that all the stakeholders should be satisfied and happy with the bill that we're pushing. So, try to use those arguments, Engineer Ilaga, doon sa mga ibang stakeholders, and I believe if you would be able to present the case, well, then ma-resolve yan. Okay? Sige ho. Engineer, Mr. Pante, yes.
Good afternoon po, Your Honor. I am the President of National Master Planners Association of the Philippines. I am an engineer. But we fully support this Philippine Planning Engineer Act, Senate Bill number 592. Mm-hmm. for our upgrading for as a profession. Thank you.
Maraming salamat po sa inyo. So, isa na lang, isa na lang. Sige.
If they wish to professionalize it by being an engineering course, mm-hmm. it will probably reach a point when the two curriculum will be similar. Mm-hmm. So, and may I express the position of CHED, which was written way back in 2010, on the scope of examination, 2015, on the scope of examination, the examination for plumbing engineers shall cover 7 subject areas. Now, since CHED does not have the minimum curricular requirements for BS Plumbing Engineering program, where will the syllabus of the subjects be based? So with the foregoing, it is the position of CHED to consider plumbing engineering as a specialization or a track under the BS Sanitary Engineering program instead of creating a separate engineering program. This is the position of CHED.
Okay. That doesn't resolve anything actually. So they have their position, you have your position. You talk, if you are able to resolve it, we'll have to put this aside. But you can't, if you're going to do that consultation, you have to come in with an open mind. Because that's the only way this world will move forward. Okay? Thank you very much for that matter. We are suspending the consideration of Senate Bills number 592 and 749. So the resource person who don't have any other business, you are excused. Thank you very much for attending us, our evening. We now move on to Senate Bill number 261 and Senate Bill number 607. Conferment of a doctorate degree given to entry-level Senate Executive Service Board, Civil Service Commission. Ma'am.
Your Honor, actually we support the bill. However, we see it as more of a safety thing because of the conferment of eligibility for career service in the third level, mm-hmm. but we cannot work with SESB on the rules and regulations.
Okay. SESB, representative? Wala na si... Sino yung director niyo?
Director at Maria Antoinette Velasco Aliones po, sir.
What's your surname?
Velasco Aliones po. Good afternoon, sir. I'm Attorney Marjorie Francisco for Career Executive Service Board. The Career Executive Service Board has submitted its position paper dated April 25, 2017. The said position paper had been deliberated and approved by the governing board of the SESB, Your Honor.
Okay. So, you are?
We took on the bill, Your Honor. The Career Executive Service Board has reservations.
Reservations?
Yes, Your Honor. Since the automatic grant of Career Executive Service Officer Rank 6 to holders of doctorate degrees may be viewed as an encroachment upon the mandate of the Career Executive Service Governing Board to promulgate rules, standards, and procedures on selection, classification, compensation, and career development of members of the SES, and the authority of the President to appoint career executive service eligibles to career executive service ranks. Your Honor, it may be recalled that Executive Order Number 883 was then issued by President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo on May 28, 2010, which granted the rank of FESO 3 or higher to government lawyers in the executive department. The same was revoked on July 30, 2010 by Executive Order 3 issued by then President Benigno Aquino. EO 883 encroached upon the prerogative of the SES Governing Board as contained in Presidential Decree Number 1 and EO 292, Your Honor. However, Your Honor, the holders of a degree, doctorate degree, may be exempt from taking the executive service written examination, which is the first stage in the fourth stage process into conferment of eligibility in recognition of their educational competence, subject still to the conditions that shall be prescribed by the SES Governing Board.
Any steps niya?
We have four stages, Your Honor. The first stage for the first stage is the executive service written examination.
Okay. Next.
Then the second stage is the assessment center. Mm-hmm. The third is the performance validation, and the last one is the board interview, Your Honor. So, Your Honor.
Performance evaluation.
Yes, Your Honor. The third.
Assessment.
Assessment is the second.
Assessment of what?
Assessment center, Your Honor. It's a series of simulation exercises designed to determine whether the applicant has the capacity to advance, to managerial duties and responsibilities, and the ability to grow and develop in the bureaucracy.
Okay. So, Chair, any response?
Your Honor, the doctorate degree is fully supported as an equivalent to the CESO. Just a concern, it should be relevant to the position being handled, because the doctorate degree might not be relevant to the position, and it might be useless to the position.
So, dito, just relevant, connection, pwede natin, ano lang yan, ilagay.
Yeah, just the requirement.
Yung sinasabi mo naman, assessment, and what's that, evaluation, and interview, all of that are subjective, right?
So,
that would be referred by the proposal of Engineer De La Cruz.
Okay.
If it's a relevant doctorate degree, parang yun yun, di ba? Ano sa mga diploma ng doctorate? Wala. Wala, di ba? Wala naman.
If they want to add recognized universities can be included as a requirement.
So, pwede natin isama yun.
And I think they're...
Paano recognized? Hindi pa discriminating naman yun?
Ah, hindi po. Kasi may CHED requirements din po sa sa mga doctorate, those offering graduate studies.
So, the higher education institutions that are offering doctorate degrees all have CHED accreditations.
And if they got their doctorate from abroad, they will have to submit it to CHED for approval.
Okay. So,
Your Honor, we would also like to inform that the conferment of SES eligibility and the appointment to assessor rank, the power to appoint is still vested on the president. The Career Executive Service Board is merely recommendatory, Your Honor.
Yes, so, but ano lang naman ito, eligibility eh. Not necessarily the position, pero at least eligible ka.
Your Honor, it's since as we understand, it's the appointment to rank, since it's CESO 6. So, it's the appointment to rank po.
So, okay nga, entry level yun eh.
It's the...
Oh. Ma'am?
Sorry if I may po. I think what CESB is saying is that if you're not even if you are a holder of a doctorate degree and you're not appointed to a certain rank, you can never be a CES eligible. You cannot get that rank also. You have to be appointed to that
of position. Of course. Ganito kasi yan, ano? This law, the intention of this law is to encourage the doctorate degree holders to join government, and once they are appointed, they get that eligibility. Hindi automatic, syempre, na doctorate ka. Useless yun, kasi kung if you're not planning to enter government, di wala yun. But what is the incentive? Na mawi-waive na yun. Mawi-waive na yung requirements ng CESB. Kumaga, don't fight it. This is for the civil service as a as an institution, the bureaucracy, di ba, ma-upgrade natin. So, tama yun, ipapasok lang natin yung mga qualifications na it should be CHED recognized, and the degree should be relevant to the position. Okay, nga, if you transfer, aba, ibang usapan yun. Maging, kailangan mo na siguro i-permanent mo yung ano mo, qualifications mo bago ka pwede ma-transfer. Sige.
Ayan, sorry. Your Honor, with regard to CES eligibility po kasi, it's conferment, career executive service eligible. You can only be appointed to a CES rank once you are already ineligible. So, ayun po yung entry po level is the career executive service eligible.
I understand.
Yes po.
Kaya nga natin pinapasa to. Para ma-ano na yon, ma-wave na yon. Di ba? Tama ba? Ano ba yung nasa isip mo?
Sir, prior to appointment to CES rank 6, yeah, you have to be ineligible first po.
Kaya nga, assuming na mapasa natin itong bill na to,
mm-hmm,
that solves the problem, right? Kasi wave na eh. Wave na, kunyari, doctorate degree holder ka, ano ka na, ikaw na ngayon yung pwede ka nang i-appoint. Kasi, ano ka. Okay, but, yun na nga, no? If, for example, degree ka on a specific field. So, na-wave yun nung in-appoint ka. But, now, i-transfer ka sa iba, na ibang field in, ang ano, wala na yun. Di ba? Hindi ka eligible for the other, ano.
Sir, excuse me. Tama ba? Once you are in the pool of assess, you're already in the pool, so you can be transferred anywhere, sir.
Yes, pero kailangan ipermanent. Gagawin nga natin dito na kailangan mo i-permanent. Special ka lang. Kasi, kumbaga, parang provisional yung conferment mo. Provisional. Kasi, ano eh, kaya kailangan punuin na ngayon yung kung gusto mo masama ka sa pool, punuin may requirements. Tama ba? Okay na ba sa'yo? Attorney, ano? Francisco? Hindi pa rin.